Srimate Ramanujaya Namaha.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Hi. In this video, we're going to briefly talk about honey and the properties of honey as per Ayurveda. In recent times, there's been a lot of talk about honey as a sweetener along with sugar and jaggery. And there are some misconceptions that we would like to clear. Right. So to start with, Preeti, what does Ayurveda say about honey as a sweetener? And
so, Srini, as you mentioned, different sweeteners have different properties, and this has been very beautifully and clearly analyzed in Ayurveda. So, right. For example, the acharyas have analyzed sweeteners right from jaggery, different kinds of sugar, molasses, honey, etc.
Correct.
And they have given the properties of each of these sugars and who should use it and when they should be used.
Right.
But here's the interesting fact. Honey finds a mention in Acharya Charaka's list of substances that can be used every day, the Nithyam Hitham substances.
Right.
So this itself tells us that this is an extraordinary dravya, right? It should not be just looked at as a sweetener.
Right.
It's a herb, it's a drug, it is an anupana, it is a medium to carry things into our body.
Right.
Right? If it is this extraordinary, then it also has highly potent and specific properties that we should be aware of before we start using it.
Right.
Right? So let's look at honey. Now, honey is a very interesting sweetener. Unlike sugar, honey has two rasas or two tastes. It is madhura,
right?
Because and we can feel that it is sweet on the tongue,
right?
But it is also kashaya and its rasa,
right?
Which means it is astringent.
Astringent.
So this makes it a very interesting sweetener. It is both sweet and both astringent.
Right.
So this makes it ideal for diseases and for prakritis where we need a reduction.
Right.
Right. So therefore, we come to the interesting property of honey. Now, honey is highly, has specific and targeted action in removing blocks in the body,
right,
specifically made out of fats.
Correct.
So, therefore, it is used in madhumeha and diabetes.
Right.
This comes because of its very unique property. Usually, sweet substances like sugar are shitya or cooling in nature,
right?
But honey is actually ushna or hot in nature,
right,
which makes it a very unusual sweetener.
Right.
It is also ruksha guna, which is again very unusual in the sweet category.
Right.
Generally, substances which are sweet build the body,
right,
but honey reduces the body. So
right,
it is ruksha guna, it is ushna guna, and it has a lekhaniya or a scraping property.
Quality, right?
So, despite the fact that it is sweet, it can be used in diabetes to deliver drugs to reduce kapha aggravation in the
right
body.
And to remind, we are not saying that diabetics should use honey in their food generally. Preeti is talking about delivering drugs for diabetics through the anupana of honey.
Correct.
Right.
Now, similarly, if you in Ayurveda, many drugs which are used, to deliver medicines for cold.
Correct.
Right. Are often asked to be mixed in honey as an anupana, especially when there is a kapha aggravation, because honey is able to do two things. It is lekhaniya and it is scraping. It is kapha reducing and it is also sukshma guna. So it takes the drug deep inside the body and it helps penetrate the tissues very subtly and very deeply.
Right. And then, of course, there are a number of other special properties of honey, like that it's, for example, it is chakshushya, that
correct,
is improving eyesight,
correct,
right? Which we will come to. The other very important aspect that we wanted to talk about in this video is the contraindications. Now, it's very clearly mentioned in the textbooks that honey should not be heated as it leads to toxicity. And
right,
let's dwell on this for a minute.
Right. So, the acharyas obviously have a very clear insight as to how honey is produced.
Right.
It is mentioned as a substance created by bees.
Right.
And 8 different types of honeys are actually listed in Bhav Prakasha Nigantu.
Right.
Depending on the kind of bee that makes the honey, the kind of flowers it actually draws the honey from.
Right.
Right. And each of these have a different property.
Right.
But what is similar across all these honeys is what the acharyas say. It is the processing action that the bee does within its body that makes this honey edible and palatable for us.
Correct.
So despite the fact that the bee may go to certain flowers which are very bitter, which are very astringent and which could even be toxic to us, all these different kinds of pollen are brought together by the bee and then processed to make a substance that we can then safely consume.
Right.
Right? But this combination breaks down when we start heating it.
Right.
Right. So when we start heating it, the acharyas say that the honey breaks into its individual pollen components, where you could have the entry of pollen from a poisonous flower, for example. Right. So this is why the acharyas say that honey in should under no circumstance be heated or had in a hot dravya, because it leads to the breakdown of its individual components and we could be ingesting something which is toxic to us.
It is this potential toxicity of honey when it's heated which we really want to highlight and leave you with in this video, because it's a common misconception to see honey being used in baking, to be used as a sweetener with green tea, etc. And this is completely to be avoided as per the textual references.
Right.
More, even further, they are saying that a person with a fever in very hot weather in summers, even in those cases, honey should be avoided and to take no chances of, you know, using honey in a situation where there's heat involved.
Interestingly, whenever there is very high pitta prakriti, the acharyas tell us that a pitta prakriti person handling honey can actually render it unstable.
Correct.
It is never advised in cases of fever. So you might have this the same drug being given, but the anupana will change in case of fever.
Right.
Because in fever, where the body temperature is so high, as soon as you consume the honey, it is liable to break down within the body and release toxins.
Right. And this, of course, leads us to a very common, habit of having honey with hot water and lemon in the morning, which is completely to be avoided in this aspect of, honey becoming toxic when heated.
No, and I also want to add, there is absolutely no Ayurvedic reference to such a drink.
Right.
Ayurveda is very vast in its knowledge on ahara. And there is no such drink ever mentioned of having lemon, hot water and tea. Or lemon and hot water with honey. So this combination doesn't even exist. This is a recent phenomenon.
Right.
And again, as we've been discussing, adding honey to hot water just doesn't make sense.
Right.
You're actually going to render it with some visha properties.
Right.
Second is adding honey to tea also doesn't make sense, because honey, because of its ruksha guna and its lekhaniya property, is very vata aggravating, as is tea. So when you have honey with tea, then you have a highly vata aggravating substance, which is not suitable for most of us, because most of us have vata aggravation in general because of our use of the cell phone, because of our long commutes, etc. So all of us actually suffer from some degree of vata aggravation or the other. So for most of us, this combination will not even work.
Right. So we hope that you got a brief overview of how honey can be used and how it should not be used. And we've also written very detailed blog post, and we will share the link to the blog post, in the post below. So we hope that you enjoyed this brief post and got some insights on Ayurvedic, the treatment of honey. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanam Vastu.